why are some people healthy and others are not?
In terms of the neighborhoods in which you live, does where you live matter over and above your individual choices?
Why is it that some countries have citizens who live long and healthy lives, whereas in other countries, life is short, nasty, and brutal? Welcome to Health and Society. I am Ichiro Kawachi. I am Professor of Social Epidemiology and Chair of the Department of Social and Behavioral Sciences here at the Harvard School of Public Health.
And I'm Monica Wang, an instructor in the Department of Social and Behavioral Sciences at the Harvard School of Public Health.
This course focuses on the social determinants of health. The social determinants of health is defined by the World Health Organization as the condition in which people are born, they are educated, they grow, they work, they age.
How are these variables linked to health behaviors and health outcomes at the population level?
Having lived in three different countries in my life, that's how I became interested in why is it that some nations are healthy whilst others are not.
In this area, you'll see that the street planning and urban design is actually much more friendly to walkers and bikers than it is for drivers, as evidenced by the multiple crosswalks and the ample sidewalk space for pedestrians and for bikers.
This course, it's everything we do in our lives. It concerns what kind of family we grew up in, what sort of school we attended, what kind of job is health promoting versus health damaging, and how we should maintain our social relationship so as to be healthy ourselves and to promote the health of others.
We look forward to seeing you for our first session.
See you soon.